In this chapter, we'll discuss about the use of tags and attributes for creating form. Input tag, it is used to insert information. Where you can insert like text, where name, value, size, max length, such type of attributes are used. Similarly, name is the input tag. The value may be different, it depends upon what the type is. Here you can use more use tags like text, text box for inserting text or values, checkbox to choose multiple values like checkbox where name values are inserted, radio buttons like to choose only one value from the multiple options, okay. Password to insert security code, it is also called hidden string or text or number, okay. Here also you can specify the size and length of password. Similarly, button, okay, like submit button, reset button, okay. Similarly, text area is next step. It is used to specify the area of the text. In text area also you can use different attributes like name of tab, like value, editable information of the tab, quotes, width of text area, and rows, height of the text area. Similarly, select to create a menu that offers visitors a list of options to choose. It also contains different attributes like name of the tab, multiple, if more than one option shown at a time, size, number of options you want to display at a time. And next is option tab. Normally it is used with select tab. This tag is used to define the option to choose from the drop down list. We can use it to create drop down list. Selected, this attribute specifies the default option that appears first in the non-multiple select tab. Okay. Similarly, method property tells tab form to transfer the data to the form processor. The value for method can be post or get. Action property tells what action the form should take. Open notepad, press enter, type notepad in source program in file box, press enter, body, now close body, close HTML, okay, we can just close head, we can also close title. If you want to write tag, so the title, you can type like use of forms tags. Okay, you can also specify body color if you want to display body, busy color equal to pink, okay. Now let's use text area attribute. Let's use text text. When the type attribute value is set as text, it provides a one line area for text entry. Now let's type this tag. We can use this text text with input type attribute like input, now type equal to inside double quotation mark text text, okay, close double quotation mark, space, name equal to now what you want to store there, like first name. If you want to store first name you can type. Now what is the length of the text? suppose size equal to, sorry, what is the size of it? You can type like 20. Mostly such type of values are inserted in double quotes mark. Space, max length equal to 25. You cannot insert any text or character more than 25. Now let's close. Save the text, go to file menu, click on save. Choose the location, for example, libraries, documents. I want to save this text with the name homes.html. Okay. Now click on save. Now go to the location where you have saved this file. For example, computer, libraries, documents. Here we have saved the file with forms. Okay, double click on it. Now the forms text element is being browsed in the web browser Internet Explorer. See, the background we have set is pink and it is text box. Okay, here we can type number and text, but only of 25, because the maximum length is 25 only. Now more than 25 we cannot insert. Okay, so this is text, and let's go to text editor again. Let's use another forms element, checkbox. Now input type equal to checkbox close with double question mark, space. Now what is the name? Name equal to, now what element is stored there? For example, gender. What is the value? You can type value equal to. Now what is the name, option name that you want to display in checkbox? For example, male. Male. Okay. Now, if you want to display any text by default selected, you can use more attributes like checked, checked, checked. It is used to highlight the default value. Okay. Now close this input tab. Similarly, now save this tab, file menu, save. Go to web browser, right click, refresh. Okay, you can see this is checkbox. Okay. Now if you want to display this checkbox in different line, you know that you need to use BR tag to break the line. Go to text editor, type BR, because you want to break this line, so type BR. Now save the tag, go to web browser, right click, refresh. See, this option button, sorry, checkbox has been displayed in the second line, so it has broken the line. But in this output screen, you don't see any value, so you kun option ko lagi kun value ko lagi check lagayeko ta. Okay, now you can give the title or heading. So let's go to text editor. In the beginning you can type like mail. Okay, now save the text, go to web browser, refresh. See, the heading of this data has been displayed. Now you can check or remove the check. Insert data is male, you can check it, otherwise you can remove. Okay, now let's go to the text editor. Now You can use copy and paste method. Just copy these tags, right click, copy, and paste it. Okay, now let's make it female. Female, and this is non. And here also you can change the value, like female, this is for none. Okay, now not checked. If you want to display the first value male selected, you can use checked attribute, otherwise you can remove other checked attribute. Okay, then when you display the data, automatically the male option will be selected. You can break the line for each, because you need to display in different line. So br, you can use br tag to display in different lines. Br, you can use br tag like this. Br, okay. Now save the tags, go to web browser, refresh. See, we have listed three data heading with three checkboxes, and by default male is selected. If you want to highlight or check female by default, you can change it. Go to text editor, you can just remove the check from male and paste here. Now what happens, female option will be by default checked. Just save this tab. Now go to web browser, right click, refresh. What, see, by default male option has been selected. Like this you can use checked attribute to deselect, to select default value. Let's use another forms tag, radio button. Let's create radio button. In multiple choice question, you can get such type of radio buttons. It allows to choose only one value from the given. For example, if there are four options, you can choose only one from them. Let's create that type of option. And this checkbox, you can check multiple. See, I have chosen male also, female also, and none. But in radio button or in option button, you cannot choose multiple values. Let's see. Go to text editor. Now, let's begin. Next step, input. Now, use type attribute, type equal to. Now, what type of data? Radio. R-A-D-I-O. Radio. Okay. It is called radio button. Name, name equal to, what is the name, you can type like whatever we store, like capital city. I want to make objective type question here. Suppose capital city. Okay, it is the name for this radio button. Now value equal to Kathmandu. Kathmandu. Now if you want to input, now type attribute equal to again radio button, name equal to same capital city, capital city. You can also use copy paste method also. Value equal to Dhangadi. Okay, similarly next input type equal to radio name equal to the same value, capital CD value equal to Biratnagar, okay. Next, both option is input type equal to radio name equal to capital CD value equal to no. Okay. Now, if you want to make it by default non-selected, non-options are automatically selected. So, I mean, you page like browse motion. Okay. To make it, just type attribute like checked. Okay. Now, let's type a question in heading 1, heading 2 format or in page, inside page tab, B tab, you can type. For example, I want to use H1. Now type the text like which is the capital city of Nepal. Now, question mark, close the heading, huh? Okay, this is the question and these are the answers, but these answers are in option and here we have used checked attribute to by default to select none by default. Now save the stats. Go to web browser, right click, refresh. See, the options buttons have been appeared. Now you can type the text heading also. Now go to text editor. If you type the text at the beginning of this input tag, the data appears at the beginning. If you type data at the end, you can display the text at the end. For example, I can type here. Kathmandu. Okay, second Dhangadi. Okay, next Biratnagar and next none of the above, none of, okay, leave it none. Now save. Go to web browser, right click, refresh. See, you can get the listed options here. Kathmandu, Dhangadi, Biratnagar and none. And by default, the option has been selected none because we have checked this none. Automatically, none say web browser lagari, aapi select bada house, banera amile, checked gaya na so. Yadi Kathmandu le by default check garne bhane, you can use checked keyword checked attribute inside this input type tag. Okay. Now, in this web browser, what do you see? You can see four options. But what is the difference between this checkbox and option button or radio button? In radio button, you cannot choose multiple values. For example, if you want to choose Kathmandu, see, the check mark of or the highlighted point of none has been removed. If you choose Dhangadi, it removes Kathmandu's highlighted point. If you choose Biratnagar, it highlighted points can be removed from Dhangadi. It means you can choose only one value in options button or in radio button. So which one is the best answer? You can choose only one. But in check boxes, you can choose multiple values. For example, male, female, female, non, all you can choose. Or you can remove all also. But you cannot remove anyone. Utta bhaye pani chhannai parcha. Okay? In radio buttons or option buttons. It is the difference. Like this, we can display options or radio buttons also. Password box. Let's create password box. Go to text editor. Now again, input tag. We can begin with input tag. Input. Now type attribute you can use type equal to. Now here you want to set a password. So the input type equal to password. Password. What is the name? Name is also password. Okay. We can also type the title like in the beginning or at the end. For example, enter the security code or password. Okay, it is the title. Now it is the main tab which is used to insert password. Now save this tab. Go to web browser. Right click, refresh. See, the password box has been appeared. You have already known that to break this line or to display this line in different, you can use br tab to break the line. Go to web browser. Type br tab here. BR, it breaks the line. BR. Okay, it breaks the line. Now, let's save the tags. Right click, refresh. See, BR tag has broken the line and it has displayed the security code in different line. You can type any number or character code. Hidden form. Okay? In hidden form. Password is automatically hidden. Okay? So, let's use another form creating tab, that is button. You can see submit button, reset button, cancel button, okay button in different softwares as well as in different online forms and offline forms. Now, let's try to create such type of button. Go to text editor. Now let's type input tab. Input. Now type attribute type equal to. Now I want to create reset button. Type reset and value also reset. Okay. You can use BR tag to break the line, otherwise it can display in the same line. BR, it breaks the line. Okay, next. Now save this tag. Go to web browser. Right click, refresh. See, what is it? The reset button has been displayed. It can reset the value. Okay. Now, next. Use input tab to create submit button. Now go to text editor. Type input type equal to submit value equal to submit. Okay, now SUB. Okay, SUB MIT submit. Now let's save these tags. Go to web browser. Right click, refresh. See, reset or submit buttons have been displayed. Like this, we can create buttons in HTML document. You can see such type of button when you visit various Nepali and foreign websites. If you want to increase the space in between reset button and submit button, you can use ampersand MBSP colon semicolon. For example, you can type ampersand MBSP. It stands for non-breakable space. MBSP semicolon. Ampersand MBSP semicolon. Ampersand MBSP semicolon. Okay. Now what happens? It increases the spaces between two buttons. Now save the text. Go to web browser. Rightly replace. See the spaces of the reset button and submit button has been increased. Like this, we can create buttons also. Similarly, in various websites you can get multiple choice options. You can create list. Now let's create a list in a form. Go to text editor, select, select. Now you can give name attribute, name equal to qualification. Okay, now let's create option. In first option, let's type under SLC. We can close option tab. Next, option is SLC. Close this option. Next option +2. Close this option. Next option --. Close this option. Next option, master's degree. Close this option. Okay, so we want to list out these contents in a form. Now you can use this select tab with select closing tab. Now just save the text. File menu, save. Now go to web browser, right click, refresh. See, we have created a list. When you click on this drop down arrow, you can see such type of value. Okay, like this you can choose any value from the list. Like this you can create list or add items in list. If you want to display this list in different line, you can use BR tab. Okay, BR tab you can use. BR, it breaks the line. Now just save the text. Go to web browser, right click, refresh. See, the list has been displayed in different lines. You can choose any desired value from the list. Okay, like this you can create multiple options in a form. If you want to add title of this list, just you can go to text editor and you can type like in H1 or H2 in any format. You can type like select your qualification. Okay, the save the text, go to web browser, right click, refresh. We can get here, select your qualification. We can decrease font size also, let's decrease it. Let's write in heading 3. Now let's close this heading 3. Okay, save this text, go to web browser, directly refresh. See, you can get this heading. Now let's create a comment box where you can write different text or numbers in multiple lines. Now go to text editor. You can use this text area tab. Text area, it is used to write multiple lines text. Now text area and name equal to remax. Now how many rows and how many columns do you want to save there? For example, rows equal to 4 space, columns or columns equal to 25. You can type like title like please drop your comment here. Okay, now you can close this tab, text area tab, with closing text area. Closing text area tab. Okay. Now, go to file menu, click on save option. Now go to the web browser, right click, refresh. See, you can see and you can type your comment here. See, suppose it is good opportunity for the free students. Okay, this is comment. Okay, like this you can create comment box also for free writing. You can use text area tag to write multiple lines text. Suppose here you can see it is like a model of form. You form ko model just dekhna saknuhuncha tapai. Yadi tapai generally websites haru ma you can get reset button and submit buttons are at the end. So you can transfer, you can bring this reset button and submit button at the bottom. Now go to text editor, just copy and paste the text for reset button and submit button. Just copy, select, right click, cut. Now I want to paste this text at the end. I want to display these two buttons at the end. Now edit menu, paste. Now what happens, you can see reset button and submit button at the end. Now let's save. Go to web browser, right click, refresh. Now these reset button and submit buttons will be appeared at the end. See, Okay. If you want to display in different light, again you can use BR tab. Let's use BR tab. BR. Okay. And now save it. Go to your browser. Right click, replace. If you want to display this comment box in different line, again you can type BR tab. Like. This tag is for writing comment. Now you can use BR to break the line. Okay. Better you need to write at the end. For example, BR. You can type BR tag here. Just save it. Go to your browser. Right click, replace. See, comment box is in different line. So here you can see any title. So you can write like type your name here. For example, go to text editor and at the beginning here you have input type text name code first name. So here you can type like enter your name. So save the text. Go to web browser, right click, replace. By following the same method, you can create enter your name here, enter your address here, enter your telephone number. You can create lots of text box. Okay. Similarly, you can create lots of different types of option buttons like marital status, married or unmarried. Okay. You can say list out hobbies and in multiple choice or in check boxes or in option buttons. Okay, what is your best hobby? You can list out in option buttons like this. You can create forms in your own way. You can get such type of forms in online and offline form in Nepali and foreign websites. This is the output and this is the text editor tags. So this is the text editor HTML tags and this is the output.